Afternoon, yes. So good afternoon, all the doctors, homeopaths, homeopathic students, and my dear friends. A warm welcome to all of you. After a long time, I'm meeting you again in the form of a teacher.
Right.
Since last 4-5 days, 7-6 days, I was not there. But today I'm going to share something, and not only today, it's a series of lectures. It will take a little bit time regarding all those things, because it is a big issue which we have to learn, and which I was working with since last 30 years of my practice. Even I was a student, I was working with the biochemic medicines, and that's why I'm very happy to share something which I have learned regarding the biochemic system of medicine. Its first lecture might be a little bit theoretical plus practical or clinical aspect, because unless and until you understand the theory behind the biochemic system of medicine, you cannot apply them properly. And that's why the 12th issue book, which I have sent on the group, if you don't have a book with you, the PDF is there. You open that PDF. Unless and until you understand those first 36 pages of the book, you cannot apply it very properly. I am not going to teach all 36 pages from the book. It is not 36 pages, in fact. Out of them, lot of them are preface over there. But preface is also important for us. So we have to learn in the stepwise manner. I will going to share some part of theory and one remedy. Some part of the theory will be discussed tomorrow in the tomorrow's lecture, and again another remedy. In this manner will go. So it will not be a boring or monotonous for all of you. But this topic is very, very, very important in your practice. I'm quite sure about it. I'm quite confident that after listening all those things, then it will become very easy for the number of practitioners. Yes, we can apply this in our practice. And that's why understanding these biochemic medicines is a very essential thing. Generally, what happens, I have not seen that in any college they used to teach a biochemic medicines as a separate. Generally, this topic should be taught in as a separate 12 remedies, because the concept of biochemic medicines and concept of homeopathic medicines is rather different. And that's why one has to differentiate between what is the biochemic aspect and what is the homeopathic aspect. And that's why we're going to learn stepwise everything, sentence by sentence, but every sentence is essential for our practice in future. So warm welcome to all of you. We'll go ahead. And this is my book, The 12 Tissue Remedies of Schussler, written by William Borick and Willis Dewey. It is Vijayan Publication, and this book is very, very, very useful in your practice. On the first page only, the things are mentioned. Yes, it is comprising of the theory, the therapeutic application, the materia medica, and the complete repertory of these remedies. See, within a book, all things are comprised. All things are there in your book if you open it and understand this book properly. So, homeopathically and biochemically considered, this is not only a biochemic aspect, the homeopathic aspect is also considered while considering these remedies. And that's why you are going to learn the biochemic aspect as well as homeopathic aspect. I am not going to share homeopathic aspect of the remedies. I am going to share the biochemic aspect of the remedy, and this is what we have to learn. Then you can utilize these remedies in day-to-day practice very commonly on the basis of that. It is written by William Borick, who was everyone knows, because Borick's Materia Medica is very famous. This book is also written by him along with Willis Dewey. Both of them from the America. They are member of that American Institute of Homeopathy. They were professor in the Materia Medica and therapeutics in the Hahnemann Hospital College, San Francisco. then member of California State of Homeopathic Medical Society, both the persons who have written this or translated this into the English, lot of efforts they have taken, because originally this book written by Schussler was in German, and there were number of editions before the death of the Schussler. It was in 1898 he died, and he has published nearly about 18 editions of this book. But when Willem Borik and Dewe, who started working on this, they started with the first edition, and the recent edition which we are using is the sixth edition of the book. It is a translation of the last edition of the Schussler's original German book. So lot of contents of that book is as it is taken and translated very nicely and worked by these two people, two homeopaths, and who are stalwarts in the field of homeopathy. So we'll go ahead with the next page. This is very important, the content. So before understanding a thing, we'll go towards the content, because it is too important to understand. You open your book, you can find it out. There are four sections. The first section is general introduction, history, the theory, then the health and disease, the preparation, the dose, the biochemic and homeopathic relationships, etc. That runs from page number 13 to 35. Then what about the first 12 pages? In first 12 pages, you'll get this one page is for this content. Then thereafter, the different prefaces, the preface to the sixth edition, the preface to the first edition, second edition, third edition, all have been mentioned by Willem Borik over there, and those were very important to understand. That's why I will going to highlight those prefaces also. The second part, which starts from the page number 36, it's a blank page, and 37 to 149 page, these are dedicated to all those 12 tissue remedies. So materia medica from both the aspect is mentioned over there. That is from the biochemic aspect and the homeopathic aspect, both aspects are mentioned. Biochemic aspect, utilization of biochemic aspect is absolutely different, and when you utilize it on the basis of homeopathic aspect, it is used in a different manner, and you must know the difference. So when to use accordingly, that depends upon you. Okay, that I will discuss with you. The third part starts with the therapeutic application of the 12 tissue remedies, comprising the indications and the clinical cases, which are alphabetically arranged. So right from abscess, he starts on the page number 150, and he completes with the page number 347, different therapeutic conditions and the clinical conditions and therapeutics for them, for out of these biochemic remedies. Along with the clinical examples of the clinical cases were mentioned over there, along with the doses which are given. So it is compiled of a number of examples. So examples are collected by this Borik and Dewe from different sources, and they are added in this therapeutic application. So we have ample clinical application in this part. One must go through it. If you have any entity in your mind, a patient is suffering from piles, open that in the therapeutic part, read those 2-3 pages, and you'll understand the depth of the remedies, how to use, how they have applied with examples. So this is the third part, is very important from the book, where it has been given a therapeutic application. And last part comprises of the repertory to this 12 tissue remedy. Again, a big issue arranged upon a pathological anatomical basis. So it starts from in the similar manner as we used to use the repertory. So this starts from page number 349 onwards to 446. So this is in fact given as a table of a content, but I have added that there is an index also at the end. which is not mentioned over here in the table of contents. So page number 447 to 450, it is the index given. So if you are not finding it out, you just find it out word over there and you can find it out, open the page over there. So it's a good index given over there. So this is how one has to understand the book. You have to understand what is there, how this construction is there, if you are able to understand. And this is not a big book like other mathematics. In fact, it is a book which gives you a detailed physiological, pathological, chemical data, which no other mathematica gives. And this is Schussler's understanding. That's why he was converted to this part instead of leaving behind the homeopathy. And it is a great work done by the Schussler. We'll go ahead with the next slide. Preface to the first edition. In your book, there is a written preface only. That is actually a preface to recent edition that I have considered at the end of first three prefaces. Why preface is needed? Or why there is a need to write down, understand this preface? Number of students never reads this preface. But I always suggest that you must read the preface. Because of preface, you can understand exactly what author wants to tell you. And this is too important to understand over here, because this is the thing which is very essential to understand. See, this is the slide these are the slides which I have taken the photographs of the book. So I will going to highlight those points in every slide. What he says over there, that this book, how this 12 issue book, first edition, it was started. I think it was in the year of 1888, the first edition of this William Borick and Dewey's first edition started. So what he says, every available source from the whole of our journalistic literature and society proceedings has been made to pay tribute to us. And however imperfect, fragmentary, crude the present work is, we know that it is complete so far as the present circumstances will permit. So what they say is, we know that it is incomplete work because we have collected it right from the Schussler along with the with different journals, different views, different peoples, and we have tried our level best to make it. It is in the 1888, in the during first edition of the book, both of them said. Then what he says in the next slide, this is the second slide of the first preface of the first. And here also he has mentioned one important thing. This is one has to understand. See, everything is important. You read each and everything, but I will highlight, I will not going to go into the details of each and every word regarding the preface. But here he has compared it with two important remedies, the Natremor and Silica. Natremor and Silica were the remedies which were homeopathically proved earlier. And both of them have been proved thoroughly. That's why the data available in regarding the Natremor and Silica was a homeopathic data. And according to the Schussler, the Natremor and Silica is considered in a rather different way. But rest of the remedies were not proved to that level. And what he says over there, there is importance or there is need to prove them at the homeopathic level also, so that you can understand the difference between them. So these are two important remedies. Till that period, they were very clearly differentiated at the level of a biochemic as well as at the level of the homeopathic point of view. And last part of it, why may not the same results follow by accepting tentatively and for the time Schussler theories of the respective spheres of actions of these remedies and indications based thereon, which to say least are bold and often brilliant recommendations for their employment in disease. There was a difference in understanding of the Schussler's biochemic action, and there is a difference between understanding those remedies from the homeopathic point of view, and why they are not one and same. The reason behind that is, when he has proved it, the doses which Schussler have used, they are at the molecular level, which you can measure. They are not completely material, but they are semi-dynamic. The word which I have used earlier, because they are prepared either in 3x, 6x, 12x, sometimes even 1x, 2x, 3x, 4x, up to the 12x generally, these medicines are crude. And that's why you can find it out. There are different actions at the level of a molecule, at the molecular level. Every salt which is prepared from your body constitutional salt, it is 12 tissue salts, it is called. And these are inorganic salts which are part and parcel of your constitution. And physiology regarding these salts, everyone knows. It is given in detail in our physiology. When we learn the physiology, it is already there. What these salts are there, how they works or takes part in body constitution, and what happens after the deficiency of that salt, everything is given over there. And Schussler have looked after those things, and he considered, yes, these are the things which are essential, which are part and parcel of our constitution. And if these deficiencies of these produces diseases, definitely if you apply it at the same molecular level, then you can get the result. And he tried his level best to understand them and apply it in the similar form. And thereafter, this work he has done in detail. And that's why there is a difference in understanding of Schussler's aspect regarding the remedy and the homeopathic remedy. So there is a difference in presentation of an Natrum Murcilica from homeopathic standpoint of view and from the Schussler's point of view. What is that difference? We're going to learn when we'll go ahead. Okay. Is it clear? So we'll go ahead. Then same preface we were discussing regarding that. Whatever opposition there may be in our ranks to Schussler method, because it is not pure homeopathic practice, we believe would speedily disappear if all the critics could join in proving and confirming these valuable remedies. Introduced to the first American homeopathy, American homeopathy by our own Hering, who surely could not be accused of furthering and furthering anything absolutely mongrel and detrimental to the best interest of our school. See, Hering was very, very much for this system. He has included all those remedies in his Materia Medica. He has worked out with that. In fact, Hering has first published the 12 tissue salts. You are surprised. It is given in second preface or third preface. You will find it out that Hering has came out with the 12 tissue remedies. And he himself has utilized those remedies, and he found, yes, he satisfied at that level. So this is very important from the Schussler's point of view. Yes, he has worked it out, and along with that, when he considered, explained to the number of people, he has even the doctor Staff, you know that Staff was called by Hahnemann also in order to explain about the chronic diseases. Even Staff have published regarding the, there is one journal, you will get it in next year, you can get, I think so. So it was written in January 2, 1888. This is the first preface. And you can find it out how many people worked out with that. J.C. Morgan was there. He has commented on it. He said that there is this sentence which very important regarding the belladonna hyoscyamus aconite. What he says, without these, they would often remain incomplete in curative action and might be blamed from inevitable. We, therefore, have included in our study of the Materia Medica the homeopathic relationship at the present merely suggestive, but a department which we hope will be greatly enlarged at some future time. He has commented on these biochemical tissue remedies, and he said, without which it might be a little bit incomplete. So this is very important to understand. How many people have worked with him? There are J.C. Morgan, then S. Powell, Burdick, C.P. Currier, Henry Horton, then Leonard, then Drs. Horace, Ivins, the C.E. Fisher, Davies, Nicholson, Martin, and number of people worked out with him. And that's why it has its own importance. It is not only Suessler who was saying. He has criticized earlier, but number of people followed him later. This is the preface to the second edition of the. It was in 1890. See, after every two years, there was a different edition. So San Francisco to January to 1890, the second edition came out. And again, you will find it over there. The Materia Medica part of the work has been brought up to the date by the incorporation of the results of late proving. And we feel indebted to, especially to Dr. S.C. Allen and the medical advance, Herring's guiding symptoms, and Professor T.F. Allen. Allen's magnificent work, the Handbook of Materia Medica, which include much of the interest about these remedies. See, these are the remedies which are included over there. Why they have included? If anyone considers, so these are not remedies which are not homeopathic, this is not, and why these people have added over there? One must think about it. In fact, these tissue remedies are too precious to be used only on the pathological condition. See what he says, laid down by Suessler. They all merit careful proving in order to obtain the finer and more distinctive points for their therapeutic application. And this has been done with several and will undoubtedly be carefully done with all. And this is also my experience that I have used in many, many, many pathological conditions, and it works beautifully. If you want to hasten the rate of recovery, these are ultimate in your practice. This is the third edition preface. Here again, few important things which he has mentioned over there. The whole work has, in the third edition, it is in 1890, and this work was very important. The whole work has practically been rewritten and considerably enlarged. Everything that Dr. Suessler himself has written up to the publication of his latest, the 18th edition of the Abzekruz therapy, that is in German, is included together with much clinical experience by homeopathic profession, just account of which is scattered throughout our journals and society transactions. So, third edition when came in 1890, at that time, that was the 18th edition of Dr. Suessler's German original edition. So, this is one important thing. And how much work Suessler had done? See, he has worked out it again and again. He has also worked on the path of Hahnemann. He never kept, he has came out with first edition and immediately left thing. 18 general German editions, you can find it out how much work he has done, and this is completely retreated. Then these are the things which are very essential to understand. So we'll learn that why we have abided by his first conception and endeavor to further their development along the lines of homeopathy, Suessler prefers now to look upon the biochemic method as entirely distinct from the homeopathy. So, in 18th edition, when he came out, he said that homeopathic system of medicine is different and biochemic system of medicine is different, because the action of a medicine is absolutely different. Understanding or concept behind that is absolutely different. And that's why he explained these are two different entities. And as an all-sufficient therapeutic procedure and chemical hygiene. Thus, while he relies solely on the chemico-physiological facts, very important part, this is underlined, this chemico-physiological facts. So whatever is there, Suessler's understanding about these 12 tissue salts is regarding the physiological action and pathological action which happens at the chemical level in your body. If you are able to understand that, then you can apply these remedies very clearly and very easily. And this is in fact the understanding of a biochemical aspect of the Suessler. It is not on the basis of symptom similarity. In homeopathy, we used to use a principle of a symptom similarity. Here, it is not the principle which is used. keep it in your mind. This is very important. The homeopathic aspect of the remedy is absolutely rather different than this concept. And here he tries to explain this concept that it is the chemico-physiological facts and theories as guides for the therapeutic application of his remedies. We, accepting and utilizing all these, add thereto the indications derived from proving the only legitimate and permanent basis for drug selection in the disease. On this account, Dr. Schussler, notwithstanding, we believe that careful provings of these remedies in all potency should be made by our school. To some extent, this has been done since the publication of our second edition, notably of Kalyphos, an excellent account of which has been published by Professor H.C. Allen, MD, in the Medical Advance, the salient features of which are included in our account of that remedy. See, when Borik and Dive have prepared this edition, those editions, they have worked it out at all levels. They have worked it out both levels. What is Schussler's understanding and what is homeopathic understanding? Both parts are very, very essential to understand. And they have included both parts. And that's why in your book, it is made up of two parts. First, when we'll take today, we're going to learn the calcarea pure from this. And I will explain what is exactly homeopathic part and what is exactly the Schussler's biochemic part. Okay. And that is the last part of the third edition preface. In conclusion, we wish again thanks. So that is written in 1892. So these are three editions which came every 2 years, and thereafter two more, fourth and fifth and sixth we have, and this is the preface for this edition. So here he wants to highlight something which is also important for our point of view and our understanding our concept, and that's why in short we'll read that. Compilation largely from every available source has to supplement the author's personal experience and knowledge of these remedies. All the published data have been made use of but thoroughly sifted and critically examined. See what they have done. It is every time critically examined, every data which is they have added over there, it is every time they have critically examined. In its present form, we believe this fifth edition will be found a reliable guide to the use of 12 tissue remedies in the disease, not only so far as far as possible, according to distinctive theory of Schussler, as corrected and modified by him to the time of his death, but especially according to the finer and more discriminating method of the Hahnemann. So it was published before the Schussler's, after the Schussler's death. Schussler died in 1898. And this last edition was published in 1914. So it was very important to understand that this has been published later, and they have added number of things over there along with the remedy. So remedy data is from Schussler, but in therapeutic field you have a number of examples of different cases cured over there, and those are collected from the different homeopathic journals which were prevalent or present at that time. We'll go ahead. Many German editions of Schussler have been published since the last edition of this work was issued. The therapeutic development of these remedies has made wonderful strides, and our periodical literature during the past few years has contained many records of cures wrought by them. All this has been incorporated, and this work in its present complete and revised form is only adequate presentation of the therapeutic possibilities of the tissue remedy section. So these are the things which they have included, and this is in 1st July 1914. So see how these two people worked with the same aspect with those remedies and came out with the recent edition. Now we'll turn towards understanding of the book. And we'll start with the first part. First part is rather big. I will not going to give you everything regarding this first part. It is, I think, from the page number 17, it starts, for 13, it starts in your book, the first part. 13 to 36. All those pages are related with the 35. They are related with the first part. In every day, we're going to learn few pages. because we have to learn to this aspect, theory as well as the practical part, so that it will not be boring. I think there is a 5-6 minutes timing remaining. We'll start with this, and if it closes, we'll join with the same ID. Today we have to complete Calcarea Fluor by any means, and you'll understand. Once you understand Calcarea Fluor, you'll start using it from tomorrow. I'm quite sure about it. Once you understand this aspect of Schussler, but before that, we'll study little bit theory. See, he has mentioned both the things simultaneously. He has given reference with this Samuel Hahnemann. He was from the German. Schussler was from German only. And he is a good homeopathic physician. He learned in detail regarding the Materia Medica. But when he studied, he was a good physiologist and pathologist. And that's why he turned towards this aspect, keeping in the view regarding all pathophysiological actions, and ultimately came out with his 12 tissue salt. So he, in order to explain history of this, Samuel Hahnemann have also worked out with these three things. It was his provings of lime and salts and potash and silica. These are the remedies which have been introduced by Samuel Hahnemann in his homeopathic Materia Medica. So they were nothing but the tissue remedies. Only thing is that Hahnemann proved it in a different manner, and he has proved it in a different manner. Then later in 1832, Stapp's archive to the great importance as remedies of essential component parts of the human body. He has written, he has published it in a paper regarding these 12 tissue remedies. It was in 1832, and in the same journal in 1846, Constantine Hering have also mentioned. See, these are the people who have worked out with the biochemical remedies. And what Constantine Hering says, all constituents of the human body principally act on the organs wherein they have a function. All fulfill their functions when they are the cause of the symptom. This from the pen of that remarkable genius in the field of Materia Medica, Constantine Hering. See, this is the history. And still it is overlooked. We are not going into the understanding of this remedy. And once you understand, then you will understand the benefit of it in your practice. We'll go ahead. Dachanantar, afterwards, who has worked? Gravois was there. He has also written in his textbook regarding it. But at the same time, Schussler have mentioned Dr. Schussler of Oldenburg, Germany. He has written, to develop this suggestion and make idea of foreshadowed in them the basis of new system. In March 1873, an article entitled "An Abridged Homeopathic Therapeutics." Abridged. Abridged means what? It is a bridge between the homeopathy and 12 tissue. A bridge, common connection between homeopathy and the biochemic system. It was published in 1873. But it was published on the basis of that it is part and parcel of homeopathy. But when, at the end, when he came out with the 18th edition of the 12 tissue remedies, at that time he said it is completely different than the homeopathy. And this was very important. That itself means that he was working on his remedies again and again. And when he understood the exact concept of it, then he was complete thorough with his system, and he mentioned that it is completely different than homeopathic aspect. In the similar part, he has mentioned one more person. He was mentioned by one more person, Dr. Lorbecher of Leipzig, came out with the in the same journal with some critical considerations of it. And what has done? The Schussler came out again by giving detailed account of all those things. He has incorporated again. So there was a controversy was going on, and every time the Schussler was again and again giving answers to them. Then in the Medical Investigator, May 9, 1873, Dr. Constantine Hering have written 12 tissue remedies. See, this he was the first who has written all things regarding the 12 tissue remedies, and it was first by Constantine Hering over there. And what he said, recommended for investigation by this great teacher of our school. Several editions were published in rapid succession, from which this historical sketch is mainly derived, and following these appeared in translation of 12 German edition by J.T. O'Connor and one by M. Docity Walker. So these are the, there are number of editions came into existence regarding the Süssler. 25th general German edition was there. Dr. Süssler, previous to his death, which occurred early in 1898, published the 25th German edition, in which the application of several of remedies had been greatly enlarged and considerable new matter added, all of which we incorporated in this work. So this edition has been translated to English and we are using this. So this is